Hi students, this is Mrs. Johnson and I'm telling you about the agenda for today. So the first task is to hand in the mass versus weight lab that we started last class. Many of you handed it in last class and that's fine. If you took it home for homework, make sure it gets turned in today. If you're looking at your paper and you realize that you didn't answer the questions on the back, please do not just copy your neighbor's paper. Take a few minutes and actually think about the answers and try to give it your best effort. It's likely that this material, the mass versus weight stuff, will show up on the final exam, so it's important that you are familiar with it and that you've done your best to answer these questions. The second assignment for today is the planetary postcard assignment. This is the last assessment grade for this quarter, so it can either help your grade or it can hurt your grade. Hopefully help. It should be a nice little easy project for you to do. So here's what you're going to need for the planetary postcard assignment. You'll need a computer to do some research, and you can get that in a moment. You'll need this handout, which you can also get in a moment. And then you'll ultimately need some craft supplies, which you know where those are located in the classroom. So here's how the assignment works. I'm looking at your handout. Okay, it says, pick a planet in our solar system that interests you. You can choose any planet except Earth, and this includes the dwarf planet Pluto if you're interested in that, just not Earth. Pretend that you're visiting the planet and writing a postcard to your family or friends back home on Earth. Your postcard should include the information on this list. So if you're looking at me and you're like, I have no idea what a postcard is because I've never sent one before. It's what people used to send or still sometimes send to family and friends when they're off visiting a cool place. When you are off visiting a cool place, you would send one to a family or a friend. So this is an example of what someone did in the past for the planetary postcard project. This is a little postcard-sized piece of paper, right? The front of the postcard has a picture of the planet that the student was visiting. And then the back of the postcard is set up like an actual postcard, is what this student did. So they have their letter to a family or a friend here. And then this is pretty cute. They actually have the address and the spot for a stamp. This is how real postcards look. You don't have to make the address and the stamp off to the side. The letter is the content that I'm interested in. But you can set it up however you choose. So in your letter, you're going to include these facts about the planet that you have chosen. And this is what's really important. And this says it at the bottom of the handout. Make sure you proofread your postcard so that you've got correct grammar and punctuation. And then be creative in your writing. I'm not looking for a list of facts. I could look that up off a Wikipedia page. I want you to get a little clever with it. So for instance, this student was visiting Saturn, right? And she says, I know I used to complain about the cold back home, but it's nothing compared to here. It's about negative 288 degrees outside right now. Just a little chilly. So you can see how she kind of like got in the mindset of how it might be to visit Saturn and was a little silly and creative with her writing. So make sure you incorporate some measure of creativity there. And then the last thing that I'm going to look for on this list is a list of your sources. Okay, do not use Wikipedia. If you start with a Wikipedia page, actually go to the sources at the bottom of the Wikipedia page. You can just write in the websites that you pull your information from. Okay, so please make sure you have that. That's 3 points out of 20 for this assignment. So ultimately, you should be handing in a postcard and then this checklist of facts. And you can write on this paper, that's fine. I'm just going to be using it as a checklist and to look at your sources. Okay, here's another couple of examples of planetary postcards. This is a student who writes bigger, so he couldn't fit it on a little sheet of paper. He did a full-size sheet of construction paper, and that's fine too. His letter is written on the back. And you can see he did a little address off to the side. It's not nearly as big as the other students, but that's fine. Here's another one. This is postcard size. Right, the student just wrote the letter on the back, and they don't have an address. That's fine. The content of the letter is what's important. Here is one more, and this one's very small, a little postcard from Mars, and the writing is again on the back. If you'd rather do a fold-out card, that's fine too. It's just a little bit more space to fill in with pictures. So do whatever works for you. This assignment is going to be turned in next class. So I'd like you to get as much done in class today as possible. And then you do not have to take it home for homework. You can finish it in class using all of my craft supplies next class, which will be on Tuesday. When you finish it up and turn it in on Tuesday, I'll give you your exam review. So it's to your best in your best interest to finish it up quickly. You don't want to spend all of this class and all of next class working on it. That's going to cut into your exam review time a little bit. But you will have some class time next class to work on it and finish it up. Okay, I think that about sums it up. Please make sure that you clean up all your craft supplies if you start using those today. Please don't leave trash in the sink. And then the last thing is please, please, please make sure the computer cart is left in good shape. In fact, in period three, could I have Elliot and Justin take care of the computer cart, make sure everything's charged and in the right spot. You can leave it in the classroom. And then for period seven, if Kylie and Jolie could take care of the computer cart, making sure everything is plugged into the right slot, that would be super helpful. Thank you guys and have a great weekend.